वेरी गुड इवनिंग गाइस, दिस इज लक्ष्य अरोड़ा एंड इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू हाउ यू कैन क्रिएट अ पावर शेल स्क्रिप्ट फॉर क्रिएटिंग अ वर्चुअल मशीन ऑन एज्योर। सो एज यू ऑल कैन सी, दिस इज द पावर शेल स्क्रिप्ट। इफ आई रन दिस स्क्रिप्ट देन इट विल डिप्लॉय अ वर्चुअल मशीन ऑन टू एज्योर। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट। So ignore these lines as of now. Connect AZ account and install module. These are required when you usually deploy it using CI/CD pipelines. So I tried deploying it, so that's why I use these statements. So let us start from the basic. Like as you all can see, when we create a virtual machine in portal, we obviously need a resource group. When we create any resource, we need a resource group. So here, as you can see, we are creating a resource group first of all, which is the base. So for resource group, I'm using new AZ resource group. When you create any resource using PowerShell, you will use new term, new parameter, new AZ resource group. AZ is basically a Azure PowerShell module. So we have AZ modules, we have Azure RM module also. So here I am using new AZ modules. In case if you want to try this on your local on your own laptop, then you need to install this module, AZ module. You can use this command: install module name scope. You can select current user, just run this command simply, so you will be able to install AZ module. Okay, so new AZ resource group, it will create a basically a resource group, and here I am taking variables RG name and location is the variable. Why I am taking variable? To make my script more dynamic, so that on some day if I want to change some parameter values, let's say I want to change the location of RG and deploy it to another location, then I can simply change that value here and redeploy its script. So it will make my script more dynamic and more easy to use. Okay, so this is our resource group. So it will create the resource group. If you want, you can also start running this script, like selecting this part and click on this run selection. It will create a resource group. Then comes your storage account. So every virtual machine needs a storage account where it will store data, where it will store its operating system data and the data which you enter in virtual machine. So all the data will go to storage account. For that I am using this command: new AZ storage account. Again, new keyword you will use for creating a new storage account. AZ is the module name and storage account. And one more thing, you can also make use of IntelliSense in PowerShell, so that will help you if you are a beginner. Next comes resource group name. Storage account will be in one resource group name and it will be under location. So resource group name and location I am directly fetching from the variable RG name and location. Then you will specify the name of the storage account. This, for this also I am using this variable storage account name, demo storage, and the kind blob storage, or do you, if you want any other type of storage, then you can specify that. And the SKU, I have taken the type as standard LRS. So this is a command for creating storage account. So when you are running this command, make sure you are keeping this whole term in variable, storage variable, storage total variable. So the reason why I am keeping this, that you will come to know later by the end of this video. Okay, so till now we have created a resource group and storage account. What else we need if we create a virtual machine through portal? Just visualize, we need a virtual network also. And for creating a virtual network, we need subnets, because subnets collectively make a virtual network. So before creating virtual network, I will be creating the subnet. Subnet configuration. So here I will be configuring a subnet. I will not be adding to virtual network. I will be adding it later, but initially I will be configuring it. Again, same thing, new AZ virtual network subnet config, and the name of your subnet which you will fetch from this variable. Make sure you are using as much variables as you can. And the address prefix, every subnet has a address prefix. Here I am taking address prefix as 192.168.1.0/24/24 is the subnet mask. So, and again we are storing all these values in a variable called subnet, $subnet. So this is the command for configuring a subnet. After that I will be creating virtual network. You will use this command, new az virtual network, name of your virtual network that you will take from this variable, and the subnet name. Subnet name again you will take from this variable, demo subnet. You will specify the resource group name, variable you will take again, and the location address prefix. And like concentrate on this part, address prefix here I have taken 192.168.0.0/16, because subnet, this subnet's address prefix will be under this address prefix for VNet, because as I told, subnets are contained within virtual networks. So obviously virtual networks address space should be greater than the subnets address space. So here it was 1.0 and here I have taken 0.0, and slash subnet mask is 16 now, because I need to create a bigger address space for virtual network. And next you need to fetch this subnet configuration and store it again in the subnet variable. So why we are storing this again in subnet variable? Because we are updating subnet variable. We keep on changing the configuration. Like previously we just created the subnet configuration and stored all the address prefix, subnet name in a variable subnet, $subnet. Then we created virtual network and now we are fetching this. So to fetch we use get command, get az virtual network subnet config and the subnet name and virtual network vnet. It will all be stored in subnet again. So now the updated value of subnet will contain your subnet name and your virtual network, all this one and this value will be stored in subnet. That we will be adding this configuration to my virtual network. So I mean I will be doing, I will be adding this subnet to virtual network if we visualize it in the portal. So for that we are using add az virtual network subnet config. This subnet configuration will be added to this virtual network. Again we are taking $vnet and address prefix. This is actually another subnet we are adding, because here I have used 2.0. earlier subnet was 1.0/24, now I have used 2.0/24, and afterwards we will be using set command, set az virtual network virtual network, and the $vnet variable we need to give obviously. So till now we have created our virtual network and the subnets, storage accounts and resource group. Now comes NIC. We need to create network interface card also. So for creating network interface card we need a public IP address also. That public IP address will be associated to network interface card. So before creating NIC, we will create a public IP. For that we will be using this command, new az public IP address, and the name will come from this variable, and again the same thing, resource group, location, and allocation method is dynamic. You can set allocation method as static or dynamic also. And the DNS name, domain name label. Then we will be adding this public IP to NIC. NIC is network interface card basically. New AZ virtual network interface, name of your NIC, resource group, location, that all we have to do. Location, subnet ID, and location, and then subnet ID, public IP address and private IP address. So let us start from here. So like network interface card will be associated at the subnet level. So after location we will specify the subnet ID parameter, since we need to associate to a particular subnet. and subnet is contained within a virtual network. Okay, so for virtual network, we are specifying this dollar VNet. This is the variable which contains all the information about virtual network. Dot. When you will write these commands, it will like IntelliSense will help you in writing these commands. After dollar VNet, when you will press dot, you will get a number of options. So I am selecting subnets ID, and then comes public IP address. Public IP address ID, this you here you will specify the address dot ID. So as I told, a public IP address needs to be associated to a particular subnet, so that's why I am using this parameter public address ID. If I only write dollar public IP total, public IP total, basically this is the public IP total which contains the entire public IP address information. If I write this only and don't mention dot ID, then it will not take the ID of that public IP address, it will only take the value. That will not work. So you need to click type dot, and then you will get a number of options. From that option you need to select ID, and then the private IP address. Private IP address we also need to give to NIC. And one more thing guys, you need to keep in mind that if you won't specify the public IP address and associate it to NIC, so you will not be able to RDP to machine. You will not be able to log into the virtual machine, since if you want to log in, you need a public IP address. So that's why we are specifying public IP address. So these all things happen in backend when we create a virtual machine through portal. It is a bit complex, but slowly and steadily, if you start working on PowerShell and daily, you will practice and you will definitely come to know all these things. Then comes the configuration part of a virtual machine. Still, we are not creating a virtual machine directly. We also need to configure something. Operating system, we need to take credentials. Then in the last line, we will be using this new AZVM command. Okay, so new AZVM config. So this command we are using, since still there are some parameters which need to be configured from our end in order to fully create a virtual machine from PowerShell. So we are using this new AZVM config command. Here we are specifying the VM name, VM size. That is a basic thing which you all must be knowing if you have gone through Azure portal. So new AZVM config, VM name, VM size, all these data I have stored in VM config. So VMs, VM name and VM size is configured for a particular virtual machine. And then we will be using this get credential message. Get credential parameter. So what happens when you create a virtual machine in portal, you get the option to write your username and password, because that will be used when you log into a particular machine. So when you will use this get credential parameter, it will pop up a window in which you need to write your username and password, and it will show a message, enter credentials. All these credential data I will be storing it dollar cred variable. If you are following this in your local PC, then try to run these commands as soon as you are writing it. Like I am not executing it, so like I will be showing you how you can deploy this PowerShell script through Visual Studio in upcoming videos. So like, as if you created this command, then try executing it side by side, because you will also see how resources get created. Okay, so after credential, we need to set operating system also. Every VM has a operating system which we need to set. So here we are writing this command, set AZVM operating system. It will set some values for your operating system, like for which VM you need to set. For VM, I am taking VM config, because VM config already consists of the VM name and the VM size. So if I specify this parameter or variable, that will be enough, because VM name and VM size are contained within this variable only. And which operating system you need to specify, Windows, Linux, that I am specifying. Just type hyphen and you will get a number of list through IntelliSense. You can select from that. Then the computer name. Computer name you will be selecting from this parameter, dollar VM name or variable. And credential, obviously you will be giving credential to your virtual machine. provision VM agent. So provision VM agent, what this parameter will do, it will basically provision a virtual machine agent. See, there are lots of agents available for a virtual machine. If you want to install any extension like Qualys agent or anti-malware agent or Microsoft monitoring agent, that is a different concept completely. So if you want to add those agents automatically, then you can use this parameter and enable auto update. It means your agent will be auto updated and your machine will also be auto updated. After you have used this command, I think I've written this 2 times. So after your operating system is done, then you need to go into images, because operating system will require an image. If you are creating a virtual machine based on Windows operating system, it will require a Windows image. So in this, what we are doing, we are basically setting a source image from where the image will come, because everything is virtualized, you need an image. When we create a virtual machine, if we want a ready-made image, like we want a Windows VM, where like if you want a Linux VM on which Apache web server should be installed, we can fetch that image from Azure Marketplace. So image are basically preset configurations. So here we are setting this set AZVM source image and the VM. VM is VM config, as I told earlier, publisher name. So every image has a publisher name. That also you need to set publisher name. I have taken Microsoft Windows Server. Okay, this you can search in Microsoft documents also. You will get a list of publishers and offer. And offer name will also be there, and the SKUs and version. SKU means which type of image you want to select, whether it will be 2012 data center or 2016 Windows or Windows 10 Pro, what type of operating system you will be getting, that is called SKU. Version, you can specify the version. If you want latest version, simply specify the latest tag. And again, we will store in VM config, because we are basically working on the operating system level, which is contained within a virtual machine only. So by using this VM config again and again, we are basically updating this variable. Now finally, we will be adding this virtual network interface NIC card, which we created earlier, to our virtual machine. So here we are using add AZVM virtual network. We will be assigning this NIC to VM, and the VM again, VM config, and the ID NIC total ID is taken from here, new AZ. So whatever commands you are executing, try not to forget, like use this variable. This variable will contain all the values, and IC total dot ID, because it will take the NIC ID. On the basis of that, it will assign it to VM. Again, store it in VM config. Okay. And now comes storage total OS disk URI. First, I will tell you this command, set AZ VM OS disk. So you are basically assigning this OS disk to your virtual machines. So set AZ VM OS disk, VM again, VM config, disk name we will provide, disk name we have provided in this parameter, and VHD URI. So there are VHDs, basically, if you know the concept of VMs, OS, and there are basically VHDs, virtual hard disk. So that URI, that URL is contained within this parameter, create option from image. It will create this OS disk from the source image, which I specified here. So this is the OS disk URI. You can just pause the video and copy it. It will basically create a blob storage, like as you can see, primary endpoints dot blob. Will convert it to a string value, and in blob storage it will store all the VHDs. So like this it will happen. So after that, after we are done, we need to create the final command, new AZVM, which is a simple command. Simply type the new AZVM, resource group name, location, and VM config parameter, because it contains now all the latest updated values. So we will be using $vmconfig. So yeah guys, this was a pretty long script for creating a virtual machine. So in real time scenarios, nobody will ask you to write a PowerShell script to create a virtual machine, like, because every company nowadays has automated their stuff. They are basically have moved to infrastructure as code. So either they will be using PowerShell script or most companies will be using ARM templates on how to create a virtual machine and other Azure resources through ARM templates. So ARM templates, I think, as per my experience, that is the latest one, which is more in demand as compared to PowerShell. But still, you need to know these PowerShell steps, because that way you will learn PowerShell also, and that way you will come to know how PowerShell scripts work. In interview, it can help you definitely. So interviewer might ask what parameters and what things you need to consider before creating a virtual machine. So in that, you can answer if you want to create a virtual machine, you first need to take care of these parameters, like resource group you need to create. After that, you need a storage account which will contain all the OS disk data and data disk data. And then you need to create a subnet. After that only you will create a virtual network, because subnet is contained within a virtual network. Okay. Then you will be adding that subnet to virtual network. You will be assigning that subnet to that virtual network. Then you will create NIC, network interface card, and will be assigning a public IP address to that network interface card. And why you will be using public IP? So that you can be able to log into the server. Okay, then comes the credential part, this username and password. And then you will be creating a OS disk, operating system you will be setting, you will be selecting the image, publishers, and finally you will be creating the entire this virtual machine. So these are the steps which you need to consider. If you answer this, that is enough. No interviewer will ask you to write an entire PowerShell script, because it takes time. It took me around 1 to 2 days, and still I need to check this PowerShell script again, but it is currently working. I checked it. PowerShell script is working, but I need to check these commands, why I'm not able to connect to my Azure portal. So in upcoming videos, most probably by tomorrow or day after tomorrow, I will be showing you how you can deploy this PowerShell script using CI/CD or maybe through Visual Studio. So yeah, that's it for now, guys. Thank you for watching my video and supporting me, and take care. Bye bye. Happy learning.